Here's how you can play literally just about any game on PC with a controller using a little bit of software called AntiMicro. Now, AntiMicro is a little bit of a simplistic software, but it's been really good for what I've used it for in the past, which is mapping, you know, quick computer keyboard binds to a controller. When you actually load it up, it'll look a little bit something like this. Every time you press a button, it'll show you exactly what's being pressed at any given time. So if you have a game that doesn't have remappable keybinds, you can actually go into here and map whatever keybind you'd like to your controller. WASD, well, we can attach that to the stick. This is left stick up top here. Click on where it says no key, that's up. I'm gonna make that W. Now every time I press that, that's W. To prove that, there's a notepad, here's up. You could type like this if you wanted to. I don't recommend it, but you could. So let's make the left stick WASD. Now we have WASD. You can also control the crossover by when you click on the actual left stick portion. You can see in here all the zones that are there. So if I go straight up, even as I start moving the stick a little bit to the sides, I'm still only holding W. It's not until I hit about that 45 degree angle that the left also gets pushed in as well. To achieve a closer to normal like controller configuration, just take your diagonal range, put it all the way up to 90. And now no matter where you're at on there, it'll bleed equally up, left, down, right, whichever way you're gonna go. So it's like a typical analog stick. But let's say you're playing a game that you need to be able to aim in. You need to be able to move your mouse. Well, go over to the right stick on the up one, go down to the mouse control and make it mouse up. Now every time you push up on the right hand stick, your mouse will go up. So let's go ahead and map all of up, left, right, and down on here. Now one thing that I like to change to make the mouse a little bit smoother and it feels more like a normal controller, when you click on like up, down, left, or right, when you click on that, go to mouse settings and change the enhanced precision to linear on all four of them. Now once that's done, again, I just grabbed the diagonal range and put it all the way up to 90, and now you can see that I can make like really nice and easy figure eights with this here. You can also change the speed at which this mouse will move. If you go inside of one of these and go again back to mouse settings, you can change right here the horizontal speed and the vertical speed. I'd make sure that these are the same so that it's always a consistent move and you don't have one that's faster than the other. But the higher this number is, the faster the mouse will move, the lower it is, the slower to move. Once you have your controller set up as you would like it, you can go up here to save as, and then you can create a profile. So that way, no matter what game you're playing, you can keep consistent profiles, or you could change the profile to be whatever you would like. Once you have it named, go ahead and hit save. Let's say you want to be able to sprint, but you hate having to hold the sprint button down and you want to be able to just run indefinitely with a single press. You can also set it to toggle. Every time you press that button, it'll continually hold down whatever button you've selected it to do. To turn it off, just click that same button again. Or you can hit turbo. Now, please bear in mind that using turbo in games that have competitive shooting aspects to it, it is cheating. Please don't do that type of stuff. But in case you need an accessibility option where you can't press a button very quickly and you need to be able to do so, you can go ahead and click the turbo button there. You can also adjust some of those settings by going down into advanced. You can see where the turbo's at and you can adjust the delay, the amount, how quickly essentially that button repeats itself. Another example, maybe you want to make a workflow quicker in like a program like DaVinci Resolve or Photoshop. You can actually set multi-actions to a single button. If you go to advanced, underneath assignments, you can go ahead and click this. And let's say I want to do control, shift, escape. This will bring up task manager. I'm also going to set the time to 0 because I want them to all be simultaneously pressed. So now every time I hit A on a controller, you can see here it pulls up task manager for me. So you can set those keybinds to be whatever you would like to be able to make your workflow best for you. Also, if you have two controllers, you can also split a controller in half. This is really good for when you're doing like 2P1C or two player one controller games. My friend Norton and I were actually playing Hollow Knight a little while back. We're using two controllers and we each held half of a controller essentially. And what I did is inside of AntiMicro, I made a left-hand side of the controller and then I made a right-hand side of the controller. Norton's controller was set up to profile 2, which was the right-hand side. And my profile, which was profile 1, was set up for the left-hand side. So him and I could simultaneously control the same game at the exact same time. Because essentially it was just like using a keyboard, except with the controller. So there are some quick tips for you on how you can play just about any game with a controller on a PC, plus a few bonus tips. So I hope you have a great day and I'll see you soon. Love ya, bye.